morning. Hi, everybody. It's Lady Parts Justice League, and we are pulling out of Charleston, West Virginia. Get it? We're pulling out.
We're the ones.
We're the ones. It's a recap of week two. Joining us in week two, Moji.
Hey.
Moji is in town joining us. It was an incredible week. West Virginia is beautiful and full of awesome people who are living under repressive horribleness. And so as the world is burning, their community is also burning. But the good news is we met amazing people at the Charleston Women's Clinic. It was amazing. Charleston Women's Clinic. I can't even talk because we drank last night and I'm hungover.
The Women's Health Center of West Virginia, and it's the only clinic left in the state.
Only clinic left in the state.
And the women who run it are incredible.
Badass. And you saw our video a couple days ago when we were there about how close it was to the crisis pregnancy center, the fake Women's Health Center. And so we brought them lunch. We hung out with them. We did a whole bunch of cool get out the vote, talking about fake clinics, and talking about they have a horrible amendment on their ballot in November that basically says you will no longer have a constitutional right to abortion, and that Medicaid funding will totally be gone. And as you know, in the wake of Title X funding being shit out the window and Trump reallocating that money to clinics who don't provide abortion and won't give it to you if you even mention abortion care, and they want to focus on, what is it called? Natural family planning? Because Moji, what happens with natural family planning?
You get a baby.
Turns out that's the case. But it's like super important to come to a place like West Virginia when you see this clinic not only does comprehensive birth control care, pap smears, reproductive care, they also do visits in they drive them into the mountains, into the haulers, and they visit and help women who are financially disadvantaged continue their pregnancies. They help them with their pregnant prenatal care. They go to them, bring them in. They also help them with dental care and a whole range of, I mean, literally they will cover every cavity. If you have a cavity, they're going to make sure it's healthy. And they're incredible. We worked with the incredible West Virginia Free, canvassing. We worked with Kaleidoscope. It was just, we ate at incredible restaurants. Shout out to our show
so
last night in the green room, Ellen's,
yes,
for your rosemary hummus. What?
Yes,
go to Ellen's.
Thank you.
Ellen's was amazing. Also to Taylor's Bookstore for donating coffee. Shout out to Taylor's.
Bless.
We love an independent bookstore. And then we did a show at the bakery last night. Which
go to the bakery. The bakery's
so
amazing.
Cool.
Bakery.
So cool.
Oh my God.
Such great people.
It's this cool renovated bakery that they made into this performance space. It was totally DIY. They're new. We packed the house full of West Virginia progressives who just were so excited to find each other. The talk back was incredible. We had a million sign-ups that people are going to help out the clinic, and they're going to help out West Virginia Free because they want to make sure Amendment 1 does not pass. It was just so good. It was amazing. And now we are pulling out right now, and we're going to get in this car and head off to the capital of glamour, the Con of Ohio, Toledo, where we are joining our friends in Toledo because they are getting an onslaught of fucking crazy anti-choice extremists at their clinic this evening. So we're going to go there and be part of the wall of love and the wall of justice. And then we head off to Columbus. So that is it. The next time we speak to you on this thing, it'll be a recap of Ohio! We're pulling out!
Bye, Charleston!
You guys have anything else to say? I did all the talking.
No, that's it.
This is amazing. West Virginia is full of the nicest people you've ever met. Love it here.
Yeah, it's the best.
Coming back!
Also, the mystery hole. I didn't even get to
it. We can't
just
even cover
Google
the mystery hole.
Just Google mystery hole, because here's what I'll tell you. When I Googled Mystery Hole, it said, come to the Mystery Hole. It's been restored to its 1970s glory, and I feel like my Mystery Hole needs to be restored to its 1970s glory. And on that note, Sarah's downing Jell-O.
Chang.
It's the Breakfast of Champions. We love you. Bye.